Good morning, students. Before this lecture, we completed the solute, solvent, and solution. What is a solute, solvent, and solution that we learned before this lecture? Okay, you might have understood all the points. So today in this lesson, this is the last point, that is the solubility. Okay, now what is the solubility? See here, definition I written here. The extent which a substance may dissolve in a liquid is called solubility. Now means what? How much quantity? Extent means what? How much amount of the solute means whatever we are dissolving in water. How much amount of solute is dissolved? That is known as the solubility. Okay. See the different solids, substances. Now those are dissolving water, then everyone the solubility is a different. I mean, suppose the sugar is dissolving water, it is a soluble substance, okay. Then salt is a soluble substance in water, okay. But then the solubility is a different, okay. So today we will perform one practical, but before to that practical, see here, solubility of a solute generally increases with rise in temperature. See here, this temperature word is very important. See, before this point we learned the saturated point, okay. At the normal temperature means at room temperature, no more solute can be dissolved in that solvent. That is known as a saturated solution, okay. But if you will increase the temperature of that solution, then more solute can be dissolved. So it's depend on temperature. If temperature will increase, then solubility also increases. Well, but it is related to the solid substances, means those are dissolved in water, that all substances are known as a soluble substances, okay. If you will increase the temperature, the solubility will also increases. Remember this, means related to the solid substance, if you will increase the temperature of that solvent, then solubility also increases, okay. Means if you will get you will take one saturated solution, means saturated solution means what? Now no more solute can be dissolved in water, okay. At the room temperature means at a normal temperature. Room temperature means what? Now whatever the surrounding temperature, that is known as a room temperature. But the same solution, means suppose, see here, in this beaker, saturated solution is there, okay. Means in this one, no more solute can be dissolved. But the same, the solution, if you will give heat, okay, if you will provide the heat, then more solute can be dissolved. How this happened? Because if you will increase the temperature, now you are providing heat to this beaker and heat to that solvent, means what? Automatically the temperature will increase. If temperature will increase, means the solubility of that substance is increases. Means here if you will add the more amount of solute, it will be dissolved in a water, okay. But when you will stop heating, when you will stop heating, afterwards again, the means what? If you will decrease the temperature, the solubility will also decreases. Remember this. If you will increase temperature, the solubility of the substances increases. If you will decrease the temperature, solubility of substances decreases. Okay? Means now see here, when you will add another substance, means another solute, okay? You are giving the heat, so it will dissolve in water. But when you will stop this heat, then that layer you will see the downside. That solute you will get in a crystal form here. Okay? Why? Because you decrease the temperature, so solubility also decreases. So what is exactly solubility? Solubility means the extent to which a substance get dissolved in a liquid is called as a solubility. Extent means amount. How much amount of substance is dissolved in water, that is known as a solubility. Okay. Now see the next point, it is given. The solubility of the solid substances in a liquid increases when temperature is increased. Okay. So when temperature is increased, means a solubility of substance increases. And it is decreased when the temperature is decreased. If temperature decreases, solubility of substance decreases. If temperature will increase, solubility of substance increases. Okay, so these three points are related to the solubility. Do you understand it? Now we will perform with practically. Okay, see here it in this cup, what is given? Sugar is given. This is a salt. So these two different soluble substances. Why these soluble substances? Because it will dissolve in water. So these two substances are known as a soluble substances. Okay, here see in this beaker water is given, and this one is a spoon, this is stirrer, one beaker, this is another beaker, and after when we will get the saturated solution, that solution we will heat, then you will observe the more solute can be dissolved in that. So this one is wire gauze, this is tripod stand, and this one is candle. Okay, now we will perform. See here in this beaker, the mark it is given. Okay, so we'll take the same amount of water. Means in this first beaker we'll add salt, and in another beaker we'll add sugar, and we will see the difference in solubility. Okay, now see, I'm going to add this water in this beaker. See, 50 ml. Okay, how much water? In this beaker 50 ml water. Same amount of water we'll take in another beaker also. Same here also 50 ml water. Okay, now in this first beaker I'm going to add 1 spoon of salt. See, now we'll stir it. It will dissolve. Just stir it continuously. Then after some time, you will get the clear water. Now clear water means what? This salt is totally dissolved in this water. See now. So 1 spoon salt can dissolve in 15 ml water. We will add more. Just first, let dissolve the salt. Okay, this activity you can perform at home. Try to do this activity. Maybe you completed also this activity. Okay, if you not completed, some of the students, so today you perform this activity at home. Now see here, in this salt is dissolved. Okay, so 1 spoon we already added. Now 1 more spoon we will add. Okay, see here, 1 more spoon salt we will add. Now again stir it. See, some salt is remaining. It is not dissolving in water. This salt is not dissolving in water. So the only 1.5 spoon salt is dissolved in water. So now this is a saturated solution. Okay, why this is saturated solution? Because no more solute can be dissolved in this. Okay, now we'll perform the same in this beaker also. Okay, now what we will add in this beaker? Another beaker, we'll add sugar. See, this is 1 spoon sugar. It will take time. If it is powdered sugar, then it will dissolve fast. See, this activity you have to do. See, now mostly it is dissolved. We'll add 1 more spoon. The same, how much we added salt, the same we will see. See, if you are adding the solute in this, see the quantity is the same, 50 ml. Why? Because before this lecture, I explained you the molecular arrangement in liquid is loosely they pack. Okay, so in molecular arrangement there is a space in between. So we are adding this sugar so that sugar particle take place of that space, whichever the empty space is given. Okay, so because of that the water level will not increase. Okay, you understand it, why it is not increasing? Because they are taking place of that empty space. See, after some time you will see the sugar is totally dissolved in water. It will take a more time, so you perform at home also. So if you will observe the bowl, the sugar will dissolve more amount. Okay, it means 2 spoon, and in this what? This is the salt solution. 1.5 spoon will be dissolved in 15 ml water. Okay, so difference in both. Here 2 spoon sugar can dissolve in the same amount 50 ml water, and here in salt solution only 1.5. Okay, so it will dissolve the sugar. It is not powder, so it take time. Now we'll perform one more activity. See, now this is the saturated solution, that salt solution we are having here. See, what we will do, we will heat now this solution. Then you will see this salt will now see. Are you able to see? Salt is there as it is. Means it is a saturated solution because no more solute can be dissolved. If we will increase the temperature of this water, then solubility will increase. So salt will dissolve in water. Just to observe it, will increase the temperature now. Okay. So the our point, this conclusion is very important. After this experiment, what is the observation here? The solubility of solid substances. See here, the solubility of a solid substances in liquid increases when temperature is increased. When temperature is increased, now we are providing heat to that solution. So temperature will increase and the solubility will also increase. Means now undissolved salt solution, salt particles will also dissolve in that. Okay. So if you will increase the temperature, then solubility of substance is also increase, and decrease temperature, then solubility also decreases. Okay, so related to the solubility, we completed these 3 points. Okay, write down these points in your notebook and perform this activity at home. At least you do the till saturated point, that heating and all you don't do, only just do the saturated point. Take sugar and salt, how we perform just now, the same way you perform. Take the same amount of water in both the glasses. Beaker is not available at home, so you take the glass. Okay, same amount of water you take and just add, and whatever your observation, just try to be okay. Send on. Now we'll see it is written. Still, it is not getting. Okay, see here, when we increase the temperature, now see, mostly salt is dissolved. Why? Because now this temperature is increased. Okay, so if we will increase the temperature, the solubility also increase. Okay, do you understand these points? Okay, so what we completed today, this point, the solubility point we explained in solid the substances, if we will increase the temperature, then solubility will also increase. Now the next point, that is the solubility of the gases, that we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.